us. Because we can stand and persevere the hunger in this worldly life, but we cannot stand the fire of the hell on the day of judgment. We cannot persevere it. Because the fire of hell is much more severe in heat than whatever heat of the fire we see in this worldly life. At least 99 times more. These were the etiquettes. These were was the level of taqwa, of iman of those people who preceded us. My dear brothers and sisters, in today's age, we are Muslims, we follow Islam. But where is the level of our iman? We are not concerned about our livelihood. We don't follow the Sharia. We follow our whims and desires. Whatever comes, if it fits our needs, then we do it. And about such person, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, يُطِيلُ السَّفَرُ عَشْعَسَ أَغْبَرَ يَمُدُّ يَدَيْهِ لَلسَّمَاءِ يَا رَبِّي يَا رَبِّي وَمَطْعَمُهُ حَرَامٌ وَمَلْبَسُهُ حَرَامٌ وَغُذِيَ بِالْحَرَامِ فَأَنَّى يُسْتَجَابُ لِذَلِكَ. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that a person, he travels for long periods, his hair tousled, his feet dirty, dusty, and he stretches his hands towards the sky saying, oh my Lord, while his food is haram, his earning is haram, and his dress is haram, and he was nurtured on haram. So how his dua, how his supplications will be accepted? My dear brothers and sisters, this man has a symptom of humility and poverty. And his situation invokes pity, compassion, and a desire to help him in need. He has lost his way. His journey is long. And he feels like a stranger. He feels like alone in this worldly life. And he has lost his connection with his Lord. He has been deprived of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because his food is haram, whatever is going to his stomach. Whatever he is wearing is haram. Whatever he is living on is haram. How his dua will be accepted? That's what we feel. That we come to the masjid, we recite Quran, we give charity, we do all kinds of good deeds, but our duas are not accepted. Why? We should ponder upon it. And dear brothers and sisters, eating from unlawful means, from haram means, it affects the body of a person. It blinds the insight. It weakens the religion. It blinds the insight and it hardens the heart. It darkens the mind of the person. He is unable to think better. And it prevents him from worshipping to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with sincerity. And it entraps him to this worldly life with the dazzlement of this life. And he forgets his Lord. He forgets his maqsad, his purpose in this worldly life. This is individual loss. And unlawful means of earning also affects the community, the society. It deprives it from the mercy, from the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and at the same time, it causes the spread of disease, disaster, financial crisis, unemployment, oppression, and disputes among us. This is community-based loss and harm which we feel. And this is the result of what we practice in accordance with our means of earning livelihood. My dear brothers and sisters, there are those people who are hungry for more and more. Their hunger increases and they want to amass more and more wealth, no matter which means they adopt, whether it is halal or haram. Their example is like thirsty camel. The more it drinks, the more it wants. From eating or drinking from a sea water. So, they are not satisfied with little, and nor a lot of provision satisfy them. And they adopt every means, usually gambling, cheating, stealing, snatching, and giving less while measuring and waiting. My dear brothers and sisters, this is the time to think about our way of earning. Alhamdulillah, in this community there are people who contact us while asking about their livelihood. Even if they have a little bit of doubt, they ask for it and they change their mind right there. I share you a very recent incident. Yesterday I got a letter from a certain state from a brother, and who mentioned in his letter that he visited our community in Atlanta some time back, and he went somewhere to purchase some books. He saw a Quran, a copy of Quran, certain way, and he liked it, and he ordered for the same copy to be delivered to his estate, and he sent $800 and something to the brothers who were dealing with him. When the parcel reached him by ship, he found the other copy of the Quran which he accepted from the one he saw it and he ordered. He contacted them through mail and said that, brothers, you made a mistake. You sent me the wrong copies of the Quran, not the ones I saw and I ordered. The response he received later was that, we are done with it. The deal is final and it cannot be taken back. My dear brothers and sisters, we are Muslims. We follow Islam. We follow Quran. We follow the Sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Being Muslims, whether we are businessmen, we are consultants, we are brokers, we are workers in an office, we have to be honest towards what we are doing. We have to preserve the rights of the people. We have to fulfill our pledges, our contracts to the people. We have to stay away from deceiving, from cheating, from delaying, from being honest in whatever we are doing. And whatever is happening to us nowadays, we can see the result of the same. It's a time to think. It's a time to practice what we claim to do. But if we look into ourselves and then others, then we will feel a lot of difference where we are and what we are supposed to do and what we are doing nowadays. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enable us to understand the Quran. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enable us to understand the difference between halal and haram. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enable us to follow Quran and Sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in order to please him, in order to seek his salvation. Wa ma'alina illa al-balagh. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah.